It is a great honor for me to give my tribute to Bengt Saltin, emphasizing his integrative physiological approaches, especially in humans, and for assessing the basic and real-life muscular performance, and in particular, for his engagement in physical activity and health. Now, Bengt Saltin was a giant, standing on the shoulder of giant, and that is why he could see so much further than many others. However, he did not always agree with the other giants, but he gave his unique own contributions to science. He was the father of the ECSS. And many of us have been standing on his shoulders. I was among the first students when Bengt arrived in Copenhagen, and I was his first PhD student there. There he is in his transition from Sweden as a young, handsome professor. And when he arrived at the August Krogh Institute, that was the real playground for him, with exquisite facilities to study human exercise physiology in extreme environments, indoor. But he was most fascinated by field studies, and especially he engaged in the cycling sport for many reasons. And this was way back in the 80s when I was engaged in studying the Tour de France and delivering a nice report on this. But it is very important to notice that it is also scientifically published, because Bengt, more than any other, emphasized that what isn't published will perish. The most exotic field study is probably this one on the racing camel. He gave me a copy of this scientific publication signed with the words, "For relaxing reading." So he really knew how to evaluate his own studies. The essentials from the field studies were then brought back into the laboratory to the controlled experiment, most often to the human muscle model in terms of the one-legged knee extension that has proven viable and where many techniques were used, even beyond the muscle biopsy technique. And one of the techniques that was used was a very advanced biomechanical model to quantify the muscular work. And then this knowledge was again translated into the very applied conditions of, for instance, the Kenyan runners to explain their superiority in running efficiency. And then a few words about his engagement in physical activity and health, where he disagreed with the other giants. Because they had hard arguments with the practitioners who believed that gymnastics was healthy. But in particular, Johannes Linhart, he requested that there should be evidence for such statement, which wasn't there. And this did not change during the golden age of the exercise physiology in Copenhagen with the Three Musketeers, even though the one, Erling Asmussen, was a very talented gymnast, but he thought that gymnastics were rather a little bit risky. So no one at that time really developed the evidence for any relationship between physical activity and health. But this changed when Bengt came to Copenhagen, because he brought the evidence. It's a bit sad that we can't see the very upper one, but he was in his very early career developing a questionnaire on physical activity at leisure and work. And this is extremely highly cited. And we actually, in our group, used this questionnaire on the national working cohort in Denmark. And the interesting thing is that there were contrasting findings on the physical activity at leisure, where the more, the lower the risk for long-term sickness absence from work. In contrast to the physical activity at work, the heavier the work, the higher the risk of long-term sickness absence. So not every physical activity is healthy, and evidence is needed. Bengt brought the evidence from Sweden with publications on the leisure time physical activity, on like physical training, practical and medical viewpoints. And this, of course, as you all know today, turned international with many, many other publications. And he was of great help when in Denmark we developed the guidelines for physical activity. A cornerstone in the evidence is probably this review on evidence for prescribing exercise as therapy in chronic disease. And I was therefore very happy to learn that this publication will be updated in short. This was presented at the Saltin Symposium a few weeks ago in Copenhagen, and Bente Klarlund will be the responsible. Now, this is a real Bengt Saltin experiment, almost, because it's not on the knee extensors. But otherwise, we used all these techniques of muscle biopsies, microdialysis, and you name it. And this was focused on the study of work-related trapeziomyalgia. And this was focused on the question, can exercise at the work site improve these sort of muscle disorders? Now we could show that in myalgic muscle, there was an increased number of mega fibers, which have a capillary round fiber area that is about 40% decreased, resulting in a decrease in the oxidative metabolism. And using the microdialysis technique, we could show that the substance P among the analgesic substances we were analyzing was increased several times in those with trapeziomyalgia compared to controls. And it's a pity you may not be able to see it, but this is actually a publication Bengt is co-authoring last year. And then as to the performance of the muscle, the functional capacity was actually decreased in the myalgia compared to the controls in force and rate of force development. But most importantly, with a randomized control trial performing exercise, specific exercises, pain reduced and the functional capacity recovered to the normal condition. And this again is a publication from Bengt co-authoring from last year. And this was alongside with improvements in morphological and metabolic conditions. Now, Bengt was very happy at conferences, and that is worth mentioning here. He enjoyed organizing conferences. And just 10 years after this one, he was actually the founder, as you just heard, of the ECSS, and then organizing the second conference of the college in Copenhagen in 97. But he didn't do this alone. He was very good at engaging a lot of other people. Among others, we have here between Irene and Marianne Inger Holm, who was a turning point for all correspondents, and so ever since. Maybe like the turning torso is for Malmö. As the last I want to mention, that Bengt engaged in university admin and education, and that he very visionary embodied what since became part of the mission statement of the ECSS. He strongly advocated, that sports science is multi and interdisciplinary, and that students should be exposed not only to the natural sciences in terms of exercise physiology, but also to medical aspects, social sciences, and humanities. Thank you.